64-year-old Liberty woman has died, and the Anderson County coroner says the heat is to blame. Hollis Hamid died last night after she was found slumped over the wheel of her car in a shopping plaza. News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski joins us now. And Gabby, Hollis's best friend says all of this might have been prevented if she had been traveling in a different car.
Yeah, that's right, Carol. Her roommate and best friend told me that Hollis was driving a car that did not have air conditioning when she could have been behind the wheel of a car with a working air conditioner.
Cheryl Thibodeau lived in this Liberty home with her best friend, Hollis Hamid.
She took care of me, I took care of her.
Cheryl did not want to show her face on camera. She says Hollis was camera shy too. The women shared many things, including a love of cats and trips to doctor's appointments in Greenville. Both were supposed to have an appointment on Wednesday, but Cheryl stayed home, so Hollis went on her own.
She left here, and 5 minutes after she left, I noticed she took the wrong car.
Instead of taking this white van with air conditioning, Hollis took a green van without air conditioning.
I was worried. We were worried about the weather, not spring chickens anymore. We're not young, and the heat is bad.
Cheryl's worry turned into a reality. Hollis was found late Wednesday afternoon, slumped over the wheel of that green van in this shopping plaza on Clemson Boulevard in Anderson.
When someone realized she needed help, when they called 911, the paramedics got there. Her pulse was very faint.
Her body temperature was 109 degrees. She died of hyperthermia.
What friends and officials don't know is how or why Hollis ended up in Anderson when she was supposed to be going to Greenville. But they think her history of medical problems and the heat may have caused her to become disoriented behind the wheel.
I wish I could ask her.
A white ribbon is now attached to the mailbox of the women's home in honor of a best friend who Cheryl wishes had driven a different car.
I think she'd be alive.
Anderson County Coroner Greg Shore says Hollis's medical history, which included diabetes and asthma, likely contributed to her death. Michael.
Gabby, thanks.